Good morning, and thank you for worshiping with us today. My name is Adetokunbo Adebayo, and you're about to watch the COD News.
What I love about my dad.
My dad is a superhero. He's funny, plays games with me.
My dad also cares for me, and he likes to know how my day is going.
He's always there for me when I need him.
I love the conversations we have together.
I also love the surprises, the exciting holidays,
so many things that I just love about him.
My dad was a Bible character, I would love him to play the role as Jesus Christ.
Moses.
He'd probably be Jesus because he always does nice things to people. He helps others. I always want to follow him.
He would be Daniel.
I think my dad would be Noah.
What makes him happy is when I focus in my studies.
He loves me and he wants to make sure that I'm happy. If I'm not happy, he's not happy.
When Man United wins a football game, he's always so happy because me and him are both United supporters.
He also likes it when we do well in our studies.
My dad's favorite food is pasta.
Moi moi and fufu.
Angel.
Swallow and stew.
Egg and currency.
Yum.
Eba. Daddy's favorite food is everything.
My dad's favorite color is
orange.
Blue.
Brown. Navy blue, because he wears that a lot when he goes to work.
What I like to give him on Father's Day is lunch.
A card.
A big hug. I want to plan this with my mom. I'm hoping that after church on Sunday, we could all go out to eat together. Because all of the time, it's our dad that takes us out to the restaurant to have fun. But this time, I feel like we should all like do something for him instead.
Amazing.
Courageous.
Marvelous.
Loving. Funny.
Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
I love you, Daddy.
Happy Father's Day.
I love you. And I hope you have a great day. God will bless you and nothing bad will happen to you. All the devil's tricks will never work against you.
Now to the weekly services. Last Tuesday, we had another Digging for Gold service and the Bible reading challenge. Here is a recap.
So I studied the book of 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 5 to 6. Add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge patience, to patience temperance, godliness.
So for faith, what do you add to your faith now?
I added patience.
Patience.
Godliness.
Godliness.
Kindness. Temperance.
Temperance. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So it's not something you say, I have faith, you must add something. Sometimes faith is instant.
Yes.
Sometimes you gotta wait.
Yes.
And you must stay in the faith, in righteousness, godliness. Don't be angry. Yes. Kulu temper. And God will take you out in a most miraculous way.
Yes,
when you are born again, they have told us that it is the spirit that is born again. So how can you get your mind, your body, and the whole other part born again? How?
By renewing our
renewing your mind. How? Oh, yeah, where's that scripture now?
Romans 12:2.
Put it up. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. The change comes by the renewing of your mind, that you prove what is that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. So when you study the word, there is a renewal process. Amen? Do you understand? The way you renew your mind, you affect your thinking, because as a man thinks, so is he. You need to delete the old ways of thinking that informs your actions and change it and replace it with the new, which is the word of God. What else do you need that is so important?
Sanctification.
Yes! What is the meaning of sanctification? What does it mean?
To be washed.
To be washed.
Yes, sir.
Is that all?
To be cleansed,
yes. To consecrate.
Yes, sir.
Hmm? To set aside for a special purpose. To be transformed. Is it a one-time thing?
No, sir.
You know the blood of Jesus, there is a problem, you want to fight or whatever. I plead the blood of Jesus, bam! It happens. It's so simple, sanctification. washing, cleansing. That's why the Bible says, read your Bible, pray every day. You want to grow? You need to read the Bible. May God speak to us in Jesus' mighty name. How many times do you take your bath in a day?
3 times.
Hey, come on. Come on.
Twice a day.
Eh? So, but why did you do it 3 times? I'm not even sure you do it 2 times. How many people take their baths at least 2 times? Don't lie, you. 2 times a day. 2 times. So all of you here on this room, all of you, open all the pancake and everything. It's only once. How many times do you brush your teeth? Eh? If you do it once, you are not yet married. Because if you wake up in the morning and you want to say hi to your wife, and you do not brush at night, oh my God, they will move by. Just so you got to brush twice.
So, join us this Tuesday for another Digging for Gold service by 6:30 p.m. It's always a refreshing moment in God's presence. Congratulations to the winners that emerged from the I Am an Overcomer Bible Reading Challenge with Pastor CJ. Here is a highlight from the challenge.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 29 to 32. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace to the hearers. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby he are called unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, evil speaking, be put away from you with all malice. And be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you.
Preach it, Pastor. Have you applied it to your life practically?
So during the week, something came up. And of course, that was what even stirred me to read this scripture. You know, so I began to make excuses for the particular person. Maybe the person was not thinking about it this way. Maybe the person did not see it in this light. The Lord God of heaven expects us to forgive people if indeed we want him to forgive us.
We also had a great prayer session with Pastor Dr. Siju. Here's a recap.
Continue to pray for those children. Pray for the compassion that forgives. The compassion that turns evil to good. The empathy of God. The compassion of God. The leniency of God. The clemency of God. The grace of the Almighty. Begin to call it forth concerning them. That this prayer that I'm praying for my womb this afternoon, I connect to the mercy of the womb. I connect to the mercy of the womb. I connect to the mercy of the womb. I am the one who brought these ones forth. Ha! Ha! My Lord and my God. You are loyal. You are good. You are strong. You are almighty. The mercy of the womb. The mercy of the womb. The mercy of the womb, O Lord. That is what I'm calling upon today. That is what I'm calling upon today. The covenant which you have given to us concerning those births from our womb, they will not be forsaken. They will not be cast away. They will begin to excel. For every stage of their growth, you will be their Lord and their God. No evil eye will see them. If any evil eye seeks to see them, they shall be blinded by you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
The handmaidens will be meeting this Wednesday right here in the sanctuary by 12:30 p.m. Ladies, please save the date, invite a friend, and get ready for our weekly challenge. Come worship with us this Wednesday for another hour of worship and prayer at the Cafe Diem by 6:30 a.m. This Thursday at 6:30 p.m. we will be having our prayer, praise, and Pentecost service. It's always a refreshing time in God's presence. On Friday at 12 noon, we would have our He is Lord Praise Our service, lifting up our voices in worship of our King. Sunday school starts at 7:30 a.m. every Sunday. Please buy your Sunday school medals downstairs. All these services will hold here in the sanctuary. To keep tabs on all our services, please join the church WhatsApp group using the number on the screen.
Wow! Have you heard?
heard? Have you heard the big news? It's Dr. Shiju again. That's right. And the big news is the Arise Community Insurance Scheme, a vision of Arise Foundation. And now everyone is dancing. The market woman, the woman on the street, the village folks, the janitor, and the homemaker. There is ecstasy because the change agent, Dr. Shiju Iliomade, has raised the bar again. She gave them primary healthcare, modern hospitals, access to clean water, modern schools for education and skills development, and Empowerment Academy to put them to work. And now, their compassion hero wants to touch their life in a different way, even when they may not be around. With 15,000 naira per year, you can give cover for life or permanent disability for one person, and you can give cover to as many lives as you can. Arise Community Insurance Scheme, the gift of their lives.
You can support the Arise Community Insurance Scheme by making a minimum payment of 15,000 naira per person. And you can make a donation to the account details currently showing on your screens, or you may also support a whole community by giving most generously. God bless you as you give. Do you have a testimony of God's goodness in your life? Please share with us by sending your testimony to the number showing on the screen. Please note that the e-bulletin is available for download online. Kindly log on to the link currently showing on the screen. The Access Bank Trinity Towers branch is now open to new and existing customers. The branch offers a comprehensive range of banking services, catering to both personal and personal banking needs. Please visit the branch to carry out all your banking activities. How beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news? It's a new week and another opportunity to share your salvation testimony. To assist with the conversation, everyone is encouraged to pick up a tract by the door while exiting the sanctuary. God bless you as you do so. Once again, we'll celebrate all the fathers in the house. You are a blessing to us from heaven. Thank you for all the sacrifices that you make, the ones that we see, and the ones that you shield us from. We pray that God will continue to strengthen you and give you long life and sound health and wealth to enjoy the fruits of your labor, in Jesus' name. Thank you for listening and watching. This is the City of David, where the love of God reigns, where dreams come true, where legends are born, and tomorrow's testimony is experienced today.